Today we will do twisting of vessel. Also known as torsional stress. This happens when we have asymmetrical loading. Loading or discharging or asymmetrical ballast. So what this means is, if you have a cargo hold, main deck, starboard side, port side, and the cargo is not loaded evenly, you have more cargo on the starboard side compared to port side. So if this is hatch number one, and you have more cargo on starboard side, so your starboard forward draft will increase compared to the port side, and you will have a starboard list, let's say 1 degree starboard. Now to correct this list, if it's a 5-hatch ship, hatch 5 is here. To correct this list in hatch 5, if you load more in the port side, this is hatch 1, this is hatch 5. To correct this list, then this is also called asymmetrical loading. List will be corrected, but due to this asymmetrical loading, starboard bow draft is more than port bow draft, and in the aft, the port side aft draft is more than the starboard side aft draft. So vessel gets twisted. So this is called torsional stress. Vessel is flexible, as you can see this piece of steel. If I load more in the starboard side here, it gets twisted. And to correct this list, I load more here on the port side and it gets twisted in the opposite direction. So this is something like when you wash, let's say, a t-shirt and hang it to dry. So before you hang it to dry, you wrinkle it. So this is also the same thing, twisting torsional stress. To make this more clear, let's see a ship which is evenly loaded. That is known as symmetrically loaded. Let's say 5-hatch ship. All hatches evenly loaded. Starboard bow draft 8.0, port side 8.0, starboard midship 8.0, port midship 8.0, starboard aft 8.0, port aft 8.0. Evenly loaded. That means in this case, hatch 1 is, cargo level is almost horizontal, evenly loaded. And these are the drafts. Now in hatch 1, if I shift some cargo from here to here, so this is asymmetrical loading. In this case, you have more cargo on the starboard side, so this draft might come to 8.01 and this draft might become 7.99. And the ship is listed to starboard, let's say 1 degree starboard. To correct this list in hatch 5, which was evenly loaded, now you load more on the port, you shift some cargo from starboard to port in hatch 5, it becomes like this. And this earlier draft becomes something like 8.01 and 7.99. So now you see, the forward part of the ship is listed to starboard. Aft part of the ship is listed to port. Let's say 1 degree. Midship area of the ship has no list. This is twisting of the vessel, which is not recommended to be done. So if you have a clinometer or list indicator in the forward part of the ship, it will show starboard list. If you have a clinometer in the aft part, it will show port list. And if you have a clinometer in the midship area, it will show zero list. And this condition, if you leave it for 3 days or more, it becomes permanent. That means even after you discharge cargo, this starboard list on the forward part, port list on the aft part will remain. So this is not recommended. And this happens with unequal ballast also. If you have more ballast on number one tank starboard side, less on port, vessel gets listed like this. To counter effect, if you have more ballast on the port side aft, less on the starboard, vessel gets listed to port. Now during ballast exchange, let's say here you have DB tank number 5, DB starboard number 5. If you are using the empty refill method, if you deballast both the DBs, number 5 starboard and port together, your aft draft decreases, propeller might come out partially. So what some chief officers do is, they only deballast one part, only the starboard part, so that the aft draft doesn't become too much less. And since they deballast this, you have a port list, vessel gets port listed. To correct that list, they deballast the other side of the number one DB, number one port gets deballasted. So this is also a symmetrical ballast. And the same thing happens to twisting of the vessel, which is not permitted.